Down south in the Illawarra, they are soaked to the core. After days of heavy rain, locals are experiencing some of the worst flooding they've seen in nearly two decades. Andrew Denny reports now from storm-ravaged Shoalhaven Heads.
Howard Stevenson never thought he'd need his flood insurance until last night.
And the water came over the seawall and came in here like a torrent.
Floodwaters rose around midnight. Sandbags did little to stop it.
The river from the back here came down and came in the garage there, and we just sort of watched it coming up, up and up and up.
More than 250 millimetres has been dumped here in the past 2 days. Roads across the region are cut. Farmers forced to move livestock to higher ground. Floodwaters turned backyard swimming pools into waterholes.
Well, we've got a lot of work here.
A dam near Kiama threatened to burst. Evacuation orders were issued downstream. The sheer volume of water moving through the catchment is staggering. The Shoalhaven River has burst its banks.
We're not over it yet. I mean, there's another high tide again tonight, and as you see, it's still raining.
The clean-up won't just be at houses, but beaches all along the south coast. Wild surf has stripped metres off the dunes. It'll be months before things here return to normal.
Until then, everything here is taking a battering. The rain is easing, but will continue until the weekend. And with many trying their luck on the roads, authorities just want people to use their heads.
If it's flooded, forget it. If there is flood water, they shouldn't walk, ride and drive in the flood water there. You don't know what's in it. And another thing, you don't even know if the road is there.
Andrew Denny, 10 News.